Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn about generative AI and we are going to use Midjourney. From this video, what you are going to learn: number one, how to create and set up account on Midjourney; number two, understanding of prompts such as dash dash F, dash dash AR, 1:1, and more; number three, how to swap face using Midjourney; number four, how to generate text from any image or reverse image prompt. These are things you are going to learn from this video. Let's start it. Now open your browser and search for Midjourney. Open the website and here we have to create Midjourney account. Select your display name and then continue. Now here you have to put your email and password. After that you will receive a verification email. Just go through it and then your account will be verified. So finally, the email is verified. Now click on continue to Discord. After creating account on Discord, finally we have this interface. How to set up your account here? Just go to add a server, click on it, and then select create my own for me and my friend. You can rename your server here like this and then create. Finally, the server is created, but it is not connected to Midjourney bot. Now we have to connect it with the Midjourney bot. Just go to Midjourney and here you have to find Midjourney. We can also search here Midjourney and then press enter, then click on Midjourney bot, select Midjourney bot. Now you have to select here add to server. Select the server you created, Ahsanaq, and then continue, authorize. So this is how you can simply create the Discord account and connect your server with the Midjourney bot. Now go to your server and here we are going to put our first prompt to generate image. Now here the very important thing, that is how to write prompt. Just select this plus icon and select use apps. You can also directly select it from your keyboard. Just select slash key and then you will see an interface like this. Search here for settings and then select the settings, press enter and make sure you have all these settings. Midjourney 5.2 version and select the stylize very high and we are done here. Now after that, let me tell you one thing about Midjourney. Midjourney is I'm not sure if providing free trial right now, but you have to buy subscription for it. So how to buy subscription from Midjourney? Just press slash here, write sub on your keyboard and select the subscribe and press enter. Now click on manage account, visit site. So here is the pricing. You can select any plan according to your requirement, but I recommend you to buy a standard plan. You can see the monthly billing here, $30 per month. If you want to buy this plan in a cheap price, I have mentioned a contact number. You can contact them. They will provide you a shared account, which is very useful for learning. I already have a subscription of Midjourney. I have opened my account here. So now let's write our first prompt. Now select slash from your keyboard and then select imagine. Now I am going to write my first prompt here. So finally I have written my first prompt here. Let me tell you what is prompt. Prompt is a text, information, word, code or anything you provide to server to generate an image. It is like an instruction, like this one, a man looking at camera wearing formal dress. And then we have some parameters here, as I have written dash dash S 1000 dash dash AR 4:5 dash dash style raw. I will explain it, press enter. Now Midjourney bot is creating image according to the prompt we have provided. It will take a little time. Now let's learn about the parameters. First of all, we have this one. So what is dash dash s? S stands for stylize. We can also write it like this, and in a short form we write it like this one. Then we have a value between 0 to 1000. You can select any value between 0 to 1000. If you want to get more artistic image, you have to select a higher value. Let me show you an example here. In this image, I have used 0 value of stylize, so you can see the result. Then I have used 250, here I have used 750, and in the last image, I have used 1000. So you can see the difference between them. You can also try one by one to see the difference in your image. I hope you understand me. Let's learn one more time how to write it. Just write dash dash s space, and then you have to select your desired value. And another thing, let me tell you, if you are using Midjourney 5.2 version, then it has default value of 750. If you don't write this parameter, Midjourney automatically use this value. I hope you understand. Now next we have aspect ratio. Let's learn about, first of all, what is ratio. If you have seen 1:1, what is 1:1? The first value is width, then we have height. If we have 500 pixels of width and 500 pixels of height, and if we are creating an image for the ratio of 4:5, so what will be the value of 4:5? Now the 4 will be, which is width, will be 2000, and the height will be 2500. So this is how ratio works. There are so many ratios available. Just go to Google and search for ratio sizes. So here are the ratios: 1:1, 3:2, 16:9, which is very famous for YouTube or videos, thumbnails, and then so on. Now you have to write dash dash and then AR. AR stands for aspect ratio. This is its full form. You can also write it like dash dash aspect, as we have written here, dash dash stylize, and the short form is S. Its short form is AR. Now you have to put space, and then you have to select your desired ratio. As I am going to select 4:5, which is very famous for social media. And finally, we have learned about aspect ratio. Now we have style draw. Simply you have to write in this form. If you are going to create something realistic like human image or human character, it will create a realistic image. So this is how it is very useful. And then we have another prompt, which is no prompt. It is also very useful. If you are creating an image and you are going to avoid something, just write this parameter dash dash no, and then give the instruction like no text, no photorealistic details. So this is how you can use this parameter. Let's go back to browser. So finally the image is generated. Let me tell you once again, this was the prompt we provided and the parameters. The first parameter for stylize, the another one for aspect ratio. You can see the image ratio here. And then we have style raw, which is for human image, realistic image, and as I told you, a no parameter. It was not needed here, that's why I did not use that one. So you can see here, Midjourney created 4 images according to the prompt I provide. Just click on this image. You can see by clicking on any image, there are 4 different images. You can see the details. Now you can select which one you like the most. Like I am going to use this one, the third one. Just close it. And here let's learn about what is U1, U2, U3, U4. And then we have V1, V2, V3, V4. As we have, there are 4 images. So this one is U1. And then we have U2, U3, U4. Same as V1, V2, V3 and V4. If I want to upscale, in another term, if I want to large this one, so I have to use U1. So it will upscale a single image. If I want to get this one, so I have to select upscale 3. And if I want a similar images like this one or maybe this, then we have to select these values. These are called variation. V1, V stands for variation, U stands for upscale. I hope you understand it. Now I am going to select U3 to upscale third one. Click on it, it will generate upscale. So finally, as you can see, it has upscale. here is the final result. You can download it from here, just right click on it and save image as. If you want to delete this after the work, you can simply delete it from here. Just select three dots and then go to delete image and delete. You can also delete it. Just press Shift E on your keyboard and then you will see a delete icon. Click on it, it will be deleted. There are more features, you can try it. These are useful for more variations. I hope you understand it. And another thing, let me tell you, there are so many more parameters, but I have only told you the very useful and important for a beginner. So finally, what we have completed here till now, how to create and set up account on Midjourney, understanding of prompts such as dash dash s, dash dash ar, 1:1 and more. Now we are going to learn about how to swap face using Midjourney. Go back to your browser. First of all, what you have to do, go to your server here, add a server, and then create my own server for me and my friends. Just rename it as you want and then create. Now go back to Midjourney, search for Midjourney here to find it, then select Midjourney bot, click on Midjourney bot, and then add to server. Find the server here, SN Face Swap, select it and then continue, authorize. Finally, it is ready to go. Now another thing what you have to do, you have to copy this link, I will put in the description. Just go to your browser and paste and then enter. Now select the server as I have created and then continue and authorize. Finally, Face Swap server is ready. Now how to use it? Let me show you what we are going to do here. Now we are going to use Midjourney to create images like this. Original image and then here is edit. Now select slash from your keyboard and select save ID. Here you have to write ID name as you want. I have written AQ and then go to select your image. I am selecting this one and then you have to press enter. ID name AQ created. Now select slash from the keyboard. We have to select swap ID and then the ID name as we created AQ. I will write AQ here. Now we are going to select the image to swap. Now select the image as we generated. Hit enter. Finally, you can see the result. It was the original one and it is edited image. This is how simply you can swap images using Midjourney. I hope you understand it. If you click on plus icon or select slash from your keyboard, you will see more things here. As I have created the ID name AQ, if I want to delete it later, you can simply select the delete ID. If you want to select a specific ID, or if you want to delete all of the IDs, just select delete all and then hit enter. All the ID name you created will be removed. If you want to see the ID name, just select the slash from here and go to list IDs and then enter. There are no IDs available, that's why there is no ID name. So this is how simply you can do it. One thing more I would like to tell you here, if you are using a shared account and you want to delete your images after download, just delete them from here, go to more and delete message and delete. The image is deleted. This is how simply you can do that. Now I am going to tell you another way of swap face. The important thing is the server you created for the swap face, you have to put your prompt on that server. Once you have generated the image, now go to select slash and you have to save ID here and then go to select your image. We are creating ID name, then enter. Finally, ID name AR created. Now just go to this image, select this one, right click and then go to apps and you have to select INS Vapor. And you will see the face is swapped. So this is another way of doing this. Finally, we have learned how to swap face using Midjourney. Now we are going to learn how to generate text from any image, reverse image prompt. There are two ways I am going to discuss. The first one is just select slash from here and then you have to select describe. Select describe and then you have to select the image. This image I am going to use and then enter. Now Midjourney will provide us the prompt according to the image. You can see the image and here are the possible prompts Midjourney provided us. So this is how another way to find the prompts. The second one is search for replicate.com and here you have to select image to text. select this image. Here you have to drop a file. I want to generate prompt for this image. Submit. So finally the prompt is generated, a cartoon hamburger with a happy face surrounded by lettuce and tomatoes and so on. So finally we are going to end this video. I hope you learned something new. Till the next video, thank you and goodbye.